The same, the quad in the back?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I'm working on these towers, and you know, they're pretty plain. They're made out of slabs, but then I'm going to do some decorative things on them, which I've already started on this one. And I'll just continue the process. Just making roof tiles.
Okay.
Need a rolling pin. Now, in my opinion, watching somebody do this is kind of like watching the eggs boil. I think it's better to actually do it than to watch it. Once you get the idea, it's simplicity itself.
What tool are you using?
What's that?
What tool?
A needle tool. Let me just roll this a little flatter. Then I'm also going to cut some decorative designs in this top part of the tower, like this.
What are you using to do that? Oh, okay.
This loop tool. So I'm going to be teaching people how to make buildings, not just towers, but all sorts of different shaped buildings, in a class that starts in January, I believe.
Buildings of their choosing?
Buildings of their choosing, but we're going to focus on making them and then decorating them, or treating the surface of the clay after we build, which is what I'm doing right now to some extent. Okay. So I'm just going to cut another portal into this tower. There are a couple already, I'll show you in a second. That's one here, and one for an entryway. And the clay is still leather hard, but it's actually getting a little bit hard to work with. Not really difficult, but
can I see that one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Slip on the outside of the building. There's some white slip.
I'm sure the students will know, but what is the slip for again?
In this case, just for adding color or making it white.
Okay.
There's also slip used in the forming process to put the pieces together. But it's basically clay.
Gotcha.
In this case, it's white clay, which is similar in temperature range, etc., to the red clay that's going on. So hopefully it'll shrink at the same rate and not crack all over the place when it goes into the firing. But even if it does, it's, you know, you'll see that it's part of the design as I carve away some of this white later on in the process. Which you probably won't see right now. And we'll put several coats of this on as it dries.
Does it take a long time to dry, each coat?
It's not the coats that take a long time to dry, it's that the clay is still wet.
Oh.
So I'm adding more moisture to the clay, although it's just to the exterior. So, you know, it's going to take a few days to dry.
But the very top doesn't have a slip on it, correct?
No.
Okay.
person still putting shingles on the roof.
Mm. I was thinking the same thing. Another reason should have music. It's squeaky. Yeah.
Usually when I'm doing my demonstrations, I'm filming for the my alternative art class, I just turn the sound down and speak over it.
Mm.
So that's why I don't really think about the music so much.
Mm-hmm.
Although sometimes there's a lot of music or other noise in the background. Zoom.
Right.
How much time have I used up talking so as much as I have?
12 minutes. I think.
Put a little bit more weight on in just one area, and mm-hmm. I'll show you what we're going to do later.
Was it hard making the structure that tall?
Nope.
Okay.
It's basically a slab of clay rolled around a core, cardboard core. Because the clay is so flexible,
mm-hmm.
when it's leather hard, it's easy to make into a column.
Gotcha. Maybe you could go back and put music on.
I think I can.
Afterwards. Because the chair is not very melodic.
I think it is.
Just don't move.
So I'm going to cut bricks into, or little designs into it that simulate bricks. So the red is going to show through the white. And,
do a close up.
Just turn the thing.
This way?
Back further. Yeah, that. So I could take a little bit more time on this, but I will take a lot more time on it, but I am trying to make it seem a little used, or like a ruin.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise I would try to line up my bricks and things and my shingles on my roof.
So it's okay if it's a little imperfect.
Yeah. I think it's better for its imperfections. Just had a good idea to put a hole in the roof, but I'm going to resist that temptation at the moment. I can always come back and do it later.
A hole in the roof, why? Just
because, like I said, it's a ruin.
Gotcha. This is going down. The timer. It says.
Okay. Maybe it was set at 20 minutes.
But obviously in the class, I mean, people could kind of use their imagination as to...
What they want to build in the first place, exactly.
Yeah. You just like, you like towers.
Tower. Doesn't have to be a castle.
Right.
It could be City Hall. Or the local bakery. Or the ice cream store. Could be a village in another country. Oh yeah, I guess you could make a whole village and not just a single building.
Mm-hmm. And does somebody need a bit of experience to be able to do this? No, or?
They'll need as much experience as it takes to start.
And that's what you're there for, to help with that, right?
Exactly. The other thing is that by putting white on it, I can actually choose to color it differently. Yes, I know I wiped out my window, but that's okay. I'll just put it back in. So, anyway, I'll be continuing this project. You can see I have another tower in the background that I'll work on. And I hope that some of you will be interested in joining me in class to make buildings or villages or some sort of design that comes from your own imagination and learning how to make the finishes and bricks and shingles. And anyway, thank you. Okay, cool.